Hi everyone, so today we're going to show you how to build a project in MPLAB X for one of the PIC32 processors. So let's get started. The first thing that you need to do is load up the wiki.dot website, and what we want is Lab 1 creating an MPLAB X project. And we're assuming at this point that you've already downloaded MPLAB X and the XC32 compiler for MPLAB X. So at this point, what you want to do is open MPLAB X and you want to start a new project. So let's get started. So I'm going to go here, I'm going to say new project, Microchip embedded project, a standalone project. And because the board that we're going to be demonstrating today is very similar to some of the boards that you're using as well in the lab, is a PIC32 board. This is what it looks like right here with a flashing LED. So this PIC32 board has a particular type of processor on it. And that processor, if we switch over here, you can see, there's a board, that's the green thing. And then on top of the green thing, there is this black thing with the silver pins on it. And that's a microprocessor chip. This microprocessor chip has a name on it, and if we zoom in on this, we can see that it says PIC32MX. So, PIC32MX. So it's a 32-bit PIC microprocessor, MX family, and it has a series number 250F128B. So 250F128B. And this tells us the specific designation of the chip itself. And we need to enter this into MPLAB X. So we're going to select 32-bit microprocessor units or microcontroller units. And from here, I'm going to scroll until I get to PIC32MX250128B, like this. I click on Next. I'm going to follow along as we did in the wiki.dot site, and I'm going to select on simulator. So here is the XC32 compiler. We're choosing version 1.40 that I recently downloaded. And I'm going to call this lab01. So one of the other differences that we've got here between the wiki.dot site and what we're doing right now is the wiki.dot site is effectively asking you to import a project. We're going to create that project by copying and pasting some C code. So lab01, and then over here on the left hand side you can see that the project name is there. I right click on it, I say new other, I choose C as the category, and the file type I want a C main file. So this will give me a basic template for a main function. I click on finish using the default name, and here we go, we have a template main function in an existing file, or it creates a file for us. We're going to erase all of this in this particular case, and we're going to erase it and copy over with some C code that is very similar, not quite exactly the same, but very similar to the code that is shown in the wiki.dot site. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to paste it. I'm going to save it. So it has a call to a header file that gives us definitions for the particular chips that we're using. It has some configuration parameters that are set for the chip that configure things like the clock and JTAG and some other things like that. We have a prototype function called, or prototype of a function called delay, and we have a main function that is defined. And down below we actually have the definition for delay as well. So it's very similar to what you'll see in the wiki.dot site. There's the setting up of the port A, latch, and tri-state registers, as well as there's a call to a delay function and the modification of the latch on port A to make an LED turn on and off. And you can see on this board that that's exactly what's going on, that the LED on port A, pin 0, has been configured to turn on and off for infinity over and over again using this particular type of code. So let's go back to the wiki.site site. We've created the project, we'd selected the type of processor, we got to skip the type of header that was required, we chose a simulator, we chose a compiler, and instead of choosing XC16, we chose XC32. We named the project, and instead of moving a source file into the project, we copied and pasted text. So right here, at this point right here, we see that there's source files and lab01.c. In our case, we have source files. Oh, it's located right here, just outside of source files, newmain.c right there. And if we open the editor, which we have right here, you'll see that the functions are very similar. The main function right here has delays and calls to lat A and tristate A. Tristate A, latch A, latch A, delay, latch A, delay. And then there's the delay function right here, which is very similar to the delay function that is right here. So the next step is to build the project. And what we're looking to do is to click on the hammer and the broom. That's build and clean, or clean and build. Clean and build. And we see that we have gotten a successful build right there, just like in the wiki.site. So there you have it. Lab number one has been done. And we'll move on to lab number two next.